So the idea here with the federal by-election upcoming in the end of October, the idea here is to determine in the most thorough way possible what the religious beliefs are of the candidates who are running, because it's very difficult to conceive that a person can have strong religious beliefs that do not totally influence their political philosophies. And there are a lot of nasty things that religious people believe that are not fit to be a part of a political philosophy, especially in the modern age, where the problems that beset society and the planet as a whole are difficult and intense, and it's only science that is going to be able to solve these problems for us, and not advice given by a book of fairy tales and legend and myth. In this election, we have a fellow running for the Conservative Party named Glenn Motz, who, as near as I can determine, is an evangelical fundamentalist. Fundamentalist meaning that they believe, a fundamentalist believes in the Bible, literally. And as I previously mentioned, and I think anyone who has read the Bible or made a study of it in any way will agree that there are some very grim things in that book. Stories of people doing horrible things to other people, and stories of the imaginary God doing things. I suppose they're imaginary things as well, as if he's imaginary. But the thing about it is that there are some people who believe this totally and without reservation. And it is just stunning to think that someone like this might possibly become a political representative of the people of Medicine Hat. So in order to determine what their political beliefs are, I wrote a letter to the Conservative candidate Motz, the Libertarian candidate Johnston, and the Liberal candidate Sakamoto, and asked them basically what they believed. They were asked to answer a questionnaire, which can be viewed at www.medicinehatcardstonwarnerbyelection.ca. It was a scale that was developed by Richard Dawkins, who is an evolutionary biologist and an outspoken as well as a very well-spoken atheist. And neither or none of the potential representatives answered the questions until I prompted them. And Sheldon Johnston confirmed my suspicion that he was an evangelical fundamentalist. His responses and the responses of the other two are also at www.medicinehatcardstonwarner.ca. They can be viewed there. I discovered Johnston's beliefs via social media. I went down to Stan Sakamoto's office, and he was very forthright and very calm about his philosophies in this regard. And I think it's safe to say that his beliefs are quite secular. He is a scientifically minded individual who seems to me would surely apply the latest scientific findings and thinking to any problems and difficulties that might need to be politically resolved. But Glenn Watts was a different story altogether. I dropped the letter off to him and went later to his campaign office because he had not responded. And I was very keen on knowing what he thought. So I went into the into his campaign office and introduced myself to the receptionist. And to say the least, the reception was very cool. It was more than frosty. It was frigid. And we had some discussion there because I had responded to some posts on Motz's Facebook, and they were definitely atheist remarks, and they had later disappeared. And so I asked the receptionist about this disappearance, and she informed me that she had eradicated them from the Facebook page because they were, I think the word she used was not pertinent. They were, they just weren't useful in any way. So I thought, well, this is a kind of a strange thing for persons to do, if they in fact believe in free speech. I mean, is it then true, according to Motz and his people, that if and when they hear something they don't like, they just remove it from the public sphere entirely? Rather a coarse way of shutting someone up, but obviously they can't deal with some of these objections to their political philosophies and therefore their religious philosophies, and all they can think to do is just redact them entirely from their Facebook page. Not in the spirit of democracy by any stretch of the imagination, as far as I'm concerned, and I'm sure as far as many other people are concerned also. Anyways, Motz wasn't in at the moment, but a few minutes after I arrived, he walked in, and he saw me right away, and he knew who I was. He had read my letter, obviously, and he did not look like he was going to be very receptive to any sort of conversation we might have. And he said to me, let's take this outside. I don't think those were his exact words, but they were words to his effect. And I definitely got the feeling that there was going to be some sort of confrontation in the very near future. So out we went and stood outside his front of his office. And we immediately got toe-to-toe and nose-to-nose. And it became very heated and quite emotional, and I'm sure people can appreciate it's a little bit difficult to remember exactly what was said. The gist of it was the matter of posts on his Facebook that disappeared. And I can remember one thing that he said, because I'm sure that he I remember a couple of things that he said, actually. He said he had gone to the Facebook page, or the website, Medicine at Cardston Warner, etc., and Oh, geez. And had knew what I was getting at there, and also on my Facebook page, which I'm quite forthright about the fact that I am an atheist, and I suppose like Richard Dawkins describes himself, not only is he an atheist, but he's a militant anti-atheist, because some of us believe that this whole religious business is just sucking us down a great dark hole from which we may never emerge unless some people are vehemently opposed to it in a public way. Anyway, he had gone to my Facebook page, I'm sure, where I'd posted a number of the books that I've read, and he seemed to think that reading a few books on atheism didn't make me an expert on religion, which I beg to differ with him on that, and so will a lot of other highly educated and extremely well-spoken people, like Dawkins and Christopher Hitchens. And then he also said something like, and I'll try to give the sense of his demeanor when he said it. He said, "A lot of people have been asking me, who is this Fred Lewis?" And of course, you know, when someone is talking to you like that, I mean, you're entirely compelled to respond in a like manner. So I did, and we went back and forth in very close proximity, physical proximity to one another for a few minutes anyways, and until we got to the point where he pushed me. He put his hands on my chest and he pushed me back and he said, "You're spitting in my face." I had to laugh. Anyway, so that was the end of it. That was the end of the our little conversation, I suppose, if you can call it that. And he offered me his hand, but of course I refused it because I wasn't going to shake the hand of someone like him. And I think he just exposed himself as the kind of person who is just not only intellectually not fit to be a representative, because he believes in an imaginary character, an imaginary being that controls his life and the lives of everyone else on the planet, including everything that happens. And you know, if a psychiatrist, not knowing that all of this behavior and belief sprung from religion, would probably label him as delusional. Somebody said once that when one delusional person is called schizophrenic, but when many people are delusional, it's called religion. And I think there's a great deal of truth in that. And you know, when you're running for political office, you're under a extreme scrutiny. You know, the microscope is turned up to its highest power. And ask yourself if you want someone like a Glenn Motz, who will resort to basically physical violence, mild physical violence. That may well be true, but nevertheless, you know, you just can't start pushing people around when they get under your skin, which I obviously had done. And you know, what's he going to do if he ever gets to the House of Commons? Is he going to start pushing around his colleagues when they have a disagreement about an issue? I would think that yes, or he would certainly be tempted to. And you know, Glenn Motz is just not a person who is suitable to represent this riding. Even it doesn't matter who you are, conservative. Even if you are a conservative person and have voted conservative for a long, long time, it's must be very difficult for you to have any sort of confidence or faith that a fellow like this is going to do a good job on your behalf. Having having heard my story. Now, by all means, ask Len Watts what happened. I would dearly love to hear what other people have to say about his version of events. I went to the news after this little confrontation because I was pretty amped up. If you want a real thrill, confront a 6'2" ex-cop who is a religious fundamentalist who is running for political office and challenges by beliefs by asking him several times if he believes that the earth was created 6,000 years ago. Some people just don't like that, and they don't even have the ability to defend their beliefs, apparently, in any sort of satisfactory way. So, as I was saying, I went to the news and said to them that I might have a story that they would be interested in. So a reporter came out and took my story down, and she took notes, and I think she fairly recorded what happened. And when it was the little interview was over, she said, "Well, this might come down to or she said, "It sounds to me like it's a case of he said, he said." Well, yes, I guess I can see that sort of thing. I don't know whether there are any witnesses to our little dialogue, but it doesn't really matter one way or the other. I'm telling the truth. I think that it's not so much of a case of he said, but it's a case of one person is telling the truth and one person is not, if in fact Motz's account of the whole affair differs in any substantial way from mine. In any event, I hope this is informational in some way to people who will vote in the upcoming election, and I hope that it has some bearing on how you vote, and I hope you can see that the Conservative candidate Glenn Motz is not suitable.